So I'm showing Msty, a large language model client for Mac and Windows and Linux. It's free, just download it from Msty.app. And Msty is spelled M-S-T-Y, but pronounced Msty by the developers. So on launch, Msty starts downloading a small large language model, around 650 megabytes. So it's quickly up and running. If you've ever used ChatGPT, this is all going to look familiar. And more models, of course, can be downloaded through the Model Manager page or downloaded from Hugging Face and imported. And there's even a Hugging Face search directly within the app. Msty app is a chat client. And of course, it can connect to online services like GPT-4 and Claude. But it's designed around Ollama, the open source backbone that supports the latest models. It's just like OpenAI, but running on your computer with your own model, and by extension, available on your local network. If you stick around to the end of the video, I'll show how I'm using Apple shortcuts to access Msty and third-party apps without writing any code. But first, Misty's chat client has some nice features too, so let's get started there. The first feature is the live web search. So answers can be up to date, like getting today's weather report or summarizing a current news event. This is the sort of thing that I never used on Bing or Google, because if I'm online already, why do I need a chatbot to do a search for me? Like, the search is just right there. So I was kind of surprised how much I like this. It's nice to get a straight answer without running the gauntlet of clickbait ads, animated banners, and all the distractions. So Misty's aggregating top hits from multiple search engines and multiple websites, but I still get the direct links. And I can open the footnotes to remove bad sources and then regenerate the answer. If you want to check how much the live web update is changing the answers, another fun option is to sync a second chat, but on this version, I'll switch off the live web. And I can even open a third chat with maybe a different model. And the individual chat sessions can be saved separately. There's a whole folder system over here for saved chats. But that's gonna need a little polish. I see that getting unwieldy very fast. Now, after the live web is the quick prompt, another great feature. It's the same as the prompt library over here on this low side rail. And it's also inside the parameters, which can be changed without leaving the chat. This is the system prompt to instruct the model how to behave and how to format the responses. And we can write our own system instructions and save to this library to use again. A knowledge stack is a group of documents, text files, PDFs, whatever, that can be interrogated with the footnotes linking back to the source of the information. And there are multiple ways to combine the stacks and exclude specific documents from each search. I added a bunch of my own YouTube links so it would download transcripts from my last 10 or so videos. I can't really vouch for how well this all works. I think it's best for research topics like hundreds of pages. My 10 YouTube videos don't really give me a lot of insight. I don't know, maybe I'm not asking the right questions. But the last feature I want to show is attachments, with the coolest one being image attachments. Now, this feature needs a special model called Lava, designed to analyze visual information. I downloaded a really big one from Hugging Face with 34 billion parameters. It's slow, but it does give very detailed descriptions. Not always accurate, but detailed. And once it's done, I can use that description with a more creative model to write a short story or make an image prompt. Lots of possibilities, like maybe captioning training data or Stable Diffusion Laura. But the real power is potentially once I break out of Msty as an app and start using the Ollama server in other software. An online friend showed how to use the Apple shortcuts to send a text prompt to Ollama and instruct the AI to rewrite the text as an image prompt that then gets sent over to Stable Diffusion. My input is any text I'd copied into the clipboard. I just right-click to trigger the shortcut, and everything else is handled automatically. Another use is to instantly translate the clipboard to another language and then send the translation back through the clipboard ready to paste. I'm showing this in Scrivener, but it could in theory be any app. That's the point. My software doesn't need to be updated with a language model or a monthly subscription. I don't even need to go to other software because the instructions are wrapped up inside the shortcut and ready to use with a right click or a menu item. I think you see the potential here, and all without coding. Well, that's all I have time for today. Give this video a like if you think it might help others, and subscribe if you want to be notified of my next videos. I hope you had a learn, and I'll see you next time.